Dear Peter Jungen, dear Wolf Klintz, esteemed guests, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for inviting me to Berlin at the 7th annual conference on the renowned Columbia University. Your country's subject is highly topical in view to the future global economic development. We have a saying in Germany, do not judge the day before it is night. Now you may rightly wonder whether such a skeptical attitude is appropriate and helpful in economic matters, because as they say, 50% of business is psychology. I do not want to deny this at all. I am just saying that we should be careful and keep our eyes open. The slight tremors sent out by the Dubai crisis these days give us an idea just how fragile our economic recovery still is. Our banks, here in Germany as well, have to write off immense sums. At the same time, we are confronted with increasing demand for loans by many companies, since business is picking up again and orders start coming in. Just a few days ago, the German Chancellor held a conference on issue of credit supply. In Germany, we try a funds solution on the initiative of the Deutsche Bank in cooperation with other banking groups to prevent the risk of credit crunch. The extremely positive aspect for us Germans especially is the fact that the world economy seems to be recovering at a much faster pace than expected by many. Due to our export orientation, the immediate impact of the global finance and economic crisis had much more serious consequences for us than for others. In my homeland, Baden-Württemberg, with its high share of high-tech industries, our gross domestic product in the first half of this year suffered of a stunning 10% decline, 10%. That is no longer a downturn, but rather a downfall. Now things are getting back on track, however, only slowly and not in all industries, products, and not for all companies. The slight arrival of the economy is first and foremost due to the fact that the emerging countries, China, India, and others, have speedily returned to their dynamic growth. Demand from abroad for capital equipment of essential importance for us is currently visibly increasing, but still at a low level. Still, Germany may at present even assume the role of an economic driver for Europe. From today's perspective, this is my opinion, we may breathe easier again all over the world. Political crisis management has worked better than at the end of the 20s, at the beginning of the 30s of the last century. The recession was bad, but it did not become a depression. The decisive and well-coordinated actions of national governments and reserve banks succeeded in re-establishing confidence. And the stabilization of the financial markets led in the end of preventing an even stronger shrinkage of overall demand and production. The patient has survived, which is the most important thing. However, the medication caused some severe side effects. The price we had to pay for the stabilization in all countries is greater control by the government and overwhelming and growing national debt. Moreover, the political inhibition level has been lowered when it comes to competition distorting, subsidized and protectionist policies. The decisive test we have to pass is still in the future, instead of finding a kind of government exit strategy. On the one hand, the crisis revealed that there is a need for more governmental regulation and control of banks and financial markets. To this end, we have to create the corresponding framework agreements, which need to be international, adopt laws, and establish the required institutions. On the other hand, we have to find a way of drastically limiting the governmental interference into economic activities, since they would otherwise cause a permanent impairment of the growth drivers of a free market economy. Furthermore, I am of the opinion that the immense expansion of the money supply cannot be continued endlessly, but has to be stopped, since we would otherwise stumble from one bubble to the next. And finally, we have to consolidate our state budgets, because otherwise the next crisis will not be a banking crisis, but a crisis of governments. The downrating of Greece and maybe other countries, with the subsequent reaction of the stock exchanges, not only in Athens, should be taken as a warning to this effect. All of this is politically feasible, but it has not yet been achieved. As I said, never judge a day before night falls. The last few months have clearly shown the world has indeed become a global village. The global financial crisis left its impact literally in every corner of the world, and we realize everything hangs together. Or in other words, we are all sitting in one boat. We are just now experiencing this effect during the days of the difficult negotiation at the World Climate Conference in Copenhagen. Our need for worldwide framework agreements increases, not only with respect to climate protection. In the actions or non-actions of individuals affect the living conditions of everybody else to a greater or lesser extent, we cannot allow that everybody does as he pleases. When the balance sheets of certain banks by fair exceed of the gross domestic product of whole nations, the potential collapse of these banks is not longer a national but a worldwide issue. More regulation, more agreement and coordination at international level is linked to a certain limitation on the sovereignty of national states. I consider this to be justifiable if this is a way to reach a better balance and have a better and more effective management of the globalization. In my mind, globalization and market economy are indivisible. How could the one work and develop to the benefit of people without the other? And yet we are confronted with processes of historical dimension, which by fair exceed the economic sphere and also have a political and social component. Corporations who are successful players on the world market create transparency and set up clear rules for themselves, which is called corporate governance. They underline their social and ecologic responsibility and express the fact that the actions are governed by ethical principles. That way, we are accepted and appreciated, as well as their products in the market. I believe that we should try to achieve more acceptance and appreciation in a similar way for the systems of a free market economy, and should promote this in America, Europe, and worldwide. In Europe, we have the common umbrella of the European Union for this purpose. As you will know, I've been proposed for the new Commissioner of Energy. Energy policy is a good example. Every single member state has quite unique its own interests. But no member state, not even big ones, is capable of creating a complete and autonomous energy supply system in this century. Therefore, we need more and more cooperation. First and foremost, we need a more market-oriented approach in the energy sector, which means more cross-border trading, more division of labor, more competition for better solutions. Liberalization does not work on its own. We need better infrastructure and a legal framework for it. Free enterprise and strategic cooperation in the energy sector are not mutually exclusive. It is our political task to identify and communicate the added value of this kind integration of the citizens of Europe. We are also confronted with smaller and similar challenges in our areas, such as in social policies. There are within Europe quite different traditions of the organization of a social or even welfare state. We would be mistaken if we neglected these long-established structures and aimed at the equalization and leveling of public social systems. Nevertheless, we urgently need to achieve a better coordination and regulation in this field. Otherwise, the smooth operation of cross-border jobs and freedom of movement within Europe cannot be realized in everyday life. By the way, a certain amount of competition in this field of social policies between member states is not a bad idea. Its benchmarking and best practice may be very useful instruments in this context. E pluribus unum, out of many, one, is a motto of the United States of America. With respect to Europe, my interpretation would be yes to one umbrella, which we should make stronger and wider. But under the umbrella should be lots of space for creativity, variety, and competition. Thank you for your kind attention.
Thank you very much, Dr. Oettinger, for coming here. What we have decided is if there would be questions, Dr. Oettinger will stay for lunch. So there is a possibility to on one-on-one talks and questions. And with this, I'd like to thank all of you and the panel, of course, and the leaders of this morning panels for having served this common purpose. There's nothing now between the lunch and you except me, and therefore the lunch buffet is open, and we come back at 2:30. So quick lunch. Thank you.